How's the writing going? Is
hey,
the writing?
Trying to. I'm doing a blog. It's Gerard Alessandrini from...
Forbidden Broadway.
What was it, Alive and
Kicking? Alive and Kicking was this edition.
I was so happy. I have to tell you this in person. I told your cast, I was never so happy in my life as during that show, laughing. It was like theater heaven, I tell you. Theater critic heaven.
Well, laughing, that's the key word. That's a theater critic heaven, right?
It's like everything I've always wanted to say, you were saying on stage. I mean, so funny that, I mean... And you're back. Are you still? Is it still running?
Not this edition. We finished this edition, but we're getting ready for a new one.
So,
because, you know, we've gotten up to the shows that we got up to Cinderella, but then now I have to see Kinky Boots and Pippin and Matilda and do all that, do all my homework, and then do new numbers on that. So we'll resume later in the year with a new edition.
Well,
another new edition. I think I want to do one edition at a time now instead of keeping it running all the time because it's easier because it's too hard for the actors to do the show at night and rehearse during the day. You know,
and so. It's too hard for me to even finish complete sentences at this hour of the morning.
I'm sorry.
This champagne reception. I kept turning down champagne. When do I ever do...
I just realized my fly is down. I hope you didn't get that on
there. Well, you know, hey, it's cable. You know, anything.
It's cable.
As Joan Rivers said to me, everything helps.
She's
so
great.
So, basically, running down those shows. Did you do a Les Mis takeoff?
Oh, well, the movie.
The movie?
Yeah, right, yeah.
I missed
it. Could you believe it? I mean, finally, I thought, when we did the new edition of Live Kick, I thought, we don't have to spoof Les Mis. And then the movie came out and said, well, now we have to spoof the movie. So we spoofed Anne Hathaway. And Hugh Jackman.
I'm dying to see it, and now I have to wait till you come back again.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Well, it'll be soon. It'll go soon, and they'll be all fresh and new with all the other nominees that are here today. I get to do my research and find out.
Well, I can help you. Pinky Boots didn't get nominated for anything.
I know.
By the drama desk. How pretentious are they? Anyway.
No, that's great because they can nominate. You know, since everything's in the same pot, all of a sudden Giant is a viable new musical because it's original book, original score.
Giant on that. Right. Just talk to Brian Darcy James, the Giant himself.
Right, right. But, you know, I mean, on a real original musical, it can be nominated.
And I'm a dramatist voting member. So.
Right.
And always do. Forbidden Broadway, the show I love more than anything else. And we've got all the... I'll tell you, there's a lot in Kinky Boots that...
Yeah, that's true.
And Matilda's great.
And
just
Pippin.
The best. And Pippin, yes. Pippin, what they did was...
We have damage to do.
Yes.
Right.
We have damage to do just for you. We're getting a sneak preview here. And the night I saw it, oy vey, I just had old Jews telling jokes on, so I'm going oy all the time. The understudy was on, not Patina Miller. So I didn't see that whole part of the show.
Oh.
She wasn't very good. I don't know what the hell that character was doing there.
Oh, all right.
Interesting point. I mean, the Pippin guy was great. Uh-huh. But, I mean, what, I said Ben Vereen made a career out of this? You know, but there's a character who's a black sort of lead performer, I guess.
Right, I haven't seen it yet, but I've heard.
And it's like, it keeps interjecting, and it was like this poor woman was had enough trouble getting through the bossy moves, you know, never mind remembering all the lines and songs that night. I think her name was, well, it's not worth mentioning, but anyway. Yeah. But congratulations that you're
Thank
back.
Thank you.
And
yeah, we're well, glad to be
great
here.
Great as ever. I just loved Forbidden Broadway, Alive and Kicking. I just could not stop laughing.
Thank you. Well, hopefully we'll keep going and keep making you laugh.
It's one of the best shows. It's the best. I always send people, they ask me what to go see. I send them to your show.
Well, thank you.
The quality level is so high always.
Yeah.
So.
Well, we get a good tourist crowd, believe it or not.
Yes, I know you
from
too.
The show.
And if they can't get into other shows, they come
or
over.
Or something like that. Or they get it on some level. Or, you know.
What is less miserable than other shows? You know, you're I hear your Les Mis imitation.
I know. Well, I have to thank a lot of Les Mis. I mean, you know, I don't know if we would have run 30 years if Les Mis didn't, you know, wasn't around. And they're coming back, too.
Yes, they are.
So
they're auditioning right now.
So we have to bring, we have to do a new Les Mis version of Ben Broder. It's required.
Half an empty house. You know, I remember.
Oh, you remember that?
I wish I could quote it exactly, because if you get one word wrong, it doesn't sound as funny as it will be when you see it. Live and on stage, coming soon. Forbidden Broadway, coming soon. How about that?
That's great, Stephen.
We've
thank
got
you.
Damage to do just for you. Okay, thanks, Gerard. Thanks, great Stephen. To see you as always.